I'm Inigo Flores Ituarte, and I'm a professor at Tampere University. I received my doctoral degree in May 2017 at Aalto University, and after that I did my postdoctoral research at Singapore University of Technology and Design. In November 2018, I joined Aalborg University in Denmark as an assistant professor in manufacturing engineering. Currently, I work at Tampere University as an industry professor in digital manufacturing. My research and teaching activities position at the intersection of machine design, design engineering, material science, and information technologies. I'm specialized in digital manufacturing and design, including engineering design, material science, manufacturing technologies, automation, and industrialization of key enabling technologies, including 3D printing or additive manufacturing. During my research and teaching activity, I have developed expertise in computer-aided systems, mechatronic system design, virtual product development, material science, simulation, mathematical optimization, and data science. I'm interested in physics-based and data-driven modeling applied to process structure property performance during the engineering design process involving material science and manufacturing technologies. The manufacturing of products, both on demand and near demand, in low volumes and with high variety, is the new paradigm of modern industrial activity. Underpinning my research and teaching activity in mechanical engineering is the vision that digital manufacturing and design is fundamentally contributing to this new paradigm, and therefore it is transforming the industry and supply chains. Novel methods, including physics-based simulation coupled with data-driven optimization, is disrupting the way we design, prototype, and optimize products and services, interact with technology both at physical and virtual level, plan and organize manufacturing systems, supply chains, and society at large, and ultimately how engineering design and manufacturing activities impact on sustainable development goals, also known as SDGs. In my opinion, manufacturing needs to evolve into a collaborative network of reconfigurable and interconnected entities. We need to be capable to leverage risk in supply chain operations by designing and producing closer to demand to respond more sustainably to unforeseen events. Societies and factories of the future will need to evolve into a decentralized network of virtual firms, which are interconnected with value-adding digital manufacturing and design services. Resources must be used wisely and with a circular perspective in mind. In my view, the future of industrial and manufacturing businesses will need to evolve from value extraction models to value creation and sharing models. The raw material utilization, the engineering design, the manufacturing processes and supply chain capacity will be digitally shared between firms and public organizations to be monitored and optimized via the internet, anywhere, at any time, to serve social development goal needs. My development plan at Tampere University is organized in three interconnected pillars. Two of the research and teaching development areas are linked to engineering design, machine design simulation, data science, and mechatronic machine system design. The third is related to socio-technical aspects, sustainability, and interdisciplinary research. If we go to pillar number one, it's called Digital Manufacturing and Design, or DMD systems. In DMD, the engineering design couples with the materials design, the manufacturing process chain, and ultimately supply chain and logistics. To deal with this coupling, I'm interested in research methods for multidisciplinary design optimization, also called as MDOs, and computer-aided systems, which can enable a system designer to explore the trade-offs among objectives and ultimately make better choices. Conventional design and manufacturing can be regarded as model-based. Experts gain experience by making physical observations. The experience, together with human intelligence, derives into physical models using theoretical, experimental, and numerical methods, and we use this to better understand the mechanisms behind. On the other hand, modern design and manufacturing is data-driven, in the sense that data generated throughout the life cycle of a product or a service is utilized to positively enhance systems performance, fidelity, quality, and thus enrich flexibility and autonomy of the systems. My research and teaching activity will be a combination of fundamental and applied research to innovate into DMD systems that can exploit data. For example, if we look at 3D printing technologies, the objective is to push the limit of the technology in terms of new materials, processing capabilities, productivity, and understanding of the physical underlying principles, combining simulations and data-driven optimization. I plan to continue my research on topics related to the industrialization of 3D printing and additive manufacturing technologies and their integration with conventional processes for component functionalization and end-use applications. The engineering design process is a rich source of data. Data is spread across the entire product development process, including design concepts, experimental data, material characterization data, simulations, as well as manufacturing and planning. Hypothetically, harnessing and analyzing holistically all the data can enable faster and more efficient decision-making. However, the design space from material selection, product design, and manufacturing is narrowed down and optimized independently, without considering the complex interactions between the domains or the disciplines. The resulting trade-off is that decisions taken during material selection and product design can have an impact on manufacturing process planning, for instance. Similarly, manufacturing process optimization methods do not necessarily consider other disciplinary challenges. In sum, trade-off decisions in optimization and problem-solving poses significant challenges, with the final objective to generate feasible concepts in discrete design spaces. In order to search such spaces, the design must be defined mathematically in a problem that is neither completely understood nor necessarily appreciated. The typical engineering design approach is composed of four phases, namely planning and clarification, conceptual design, embodiment design, and detail design. After selecting a design concept, the objective of the design process is to explore configurations of the design choices that satisfy performance requirements. In a sequential product design process, disciplinary specialists strive towards optimization of objectives and satisfaction of constraints in terms of their disciplinary values. Unknowingly, they generate side effects that other disciplines have to absorb, usually to the detriment of the overall system performance. On the other hand, an horizontal design approach decomposes concurrent engineering disciplines to construct a multidisciplinary design problem formulation. The primary motivation for using multidisciplinary design optimization is that the performance at system level is driven not only by the performance of the individual subsystems, but also by their interactions. While society at large has benefited from economies of scale to create a large middle class, we need to shift gradually to a scenario where sustainability and economies of scope have a more substantial role. The upcoming research framework, both at national and international level, has taken sustainable development goals, SDGs, as its center, including a commitment to making fundamental changes in the way that our societies produce and consume goods and services. Modern companies, including both SMEs and large, operate with a collection of mostly decoupled digital and physical assets. To innovate in digital manufacturing, we need to define and explore business value-adding development activities that benefit from coupling those digital and physical assets. Digitalization of manufacturing is crucial to find heuristic solutions and multidisciplinary optimal solutions to complex problems, considering social development goals simultaneously. To this end, engaging in interdisciplinary research activities with a focus on sustainable consumption and production is fundamental. In my view, interdisciplinary research is the way to unfold the interlocking mechanisms to define new policy for sustainable innovation while serving sustainable development goals. Thank you.